We're going to be talking about 12 important safety facts about motorcycles. All right, let's jump into it, but... All right, guys, so thank you to my patrons for making this possible. Also, thank you to my patrons for hitting 400+. Now the ddfmcrew.com is available for everybody. That's absolutely free. A lot of parking lot exercises, a lot of cool things on there. So check it out. Thank you to the patrons for making it possible for everyone else to have it. Anyways, all right, so here we go. So a lot of these facts are from the U.S. National Highway Traffic Safety Institute. That was a long phrase. Anyways, a lot of the facts are from them. And so I'm not just making this stuff up. All right, so let's jump to it. Number one, everyone already knew this one. So according to the U.S. National Highway, blah, 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 motorcycles are more likely to get in a crash than cars. Now, let's take a quick thought about that. Let's do a quick little thought experiment on that. Why? Why do motorcycles get in more crashes than cars? Well, think about it. How much fun are these things? When you're having fun, you have a lower sense of like a safety factor. You think that you can handle a lot of stuff when you're having like a massive amount of confidence, maybe overconfidence. You start having crashes. Now, it just talks about crashes, not fatal accidents, this and this, but we do have more fatal accidents. So back in 2016, they did a big old little data mining survey thing. And according to NHTSA's 2016 fatal crash data, motorcyclist deaths occur approximately 28 times more frequently than deaths in other vehicles. And that accounts for all other vehicles. Oh, I need to slow down. Let's go ahead and put this on cruise control so we can kind of relax a little bit. Cruise control, 28 times more. Now just think about that again. Why? Why do we die more than other cars? Well, think about it. I mean, there's a cage. Look at a big old freaking, you got an A post, B post, C post, D post, E post, all these different things. Airbags, side airbags, front airbags, crumple zones, this and this. What do I have on here? Nothing. You stay there, buddy. So what do we, he's on his phone. What do we have on our motorcycle? Zero stuff. The only thing that's protecting my exterior is the gear. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later. But that's why we die. I fall and hit the ground. I hit a curb. I snap some bones, possibly internal bleeding, possible head injury, die. If a car hits that same exact curb, they're going to pop a tire. Maybe damage a rim. That's it. If a car pulls out and I T-bone them going 20, possible open book fracture, my pelvis splits open, all those things, possibly bleed out, have a head injury, all that stuff. If a car hits a car at 20, maybe airbags deploy, maybe. So that's why that's there. Nearly half of all motorcycle deaths in 2017 occurred on weekends. Why do you think that? Oh, I left my wallet at home. Dang it. Why do you think nearly half of them occur on weekends and not during the week? Well, it's joyriding, we're having fun. We're doing some crazy stuff. We're not riding like we're supposed to be riding. Usually during the week, it's commuting, trying to get to work, trying to get back home. That's basically it. We're not doing anything crazy. We're not taking extremely long routes through the canyon just to get to work. If you are, you got a pretty cool commute. But we're not doing that typically. So we're pretty much following the rules. We're kind of focused on one thing, getting there, getting back. When we're riding on the weekends, we're having fun. And the point of that is getting to the destination as fun as possible. That's where you gotta practice your U-turns, guys. 91% of riders killed in 2017 were males. 91%. Now, it's not on the list, but I did some reading. And I was like, why is that so high? Why is it 91% of males killed on motorcycles? Or 91% of motorcyclists that died in 2017 are males. Why? Well, 80% of motorcycle riders are male. About 20% is female, and that's rising though, so it's getting closer to 25%. But yeah, most riders are freaking males. The rider, as in the person controlling the handlebars, controlling the bike. And typically, most of them, if they get in a crash, they die. But that's crazy, 91% of riders. So even the 10%, I don't know how percentages work. Anyways, let's move on to the next one. 59% of female riders who died in crashes in 2017 were passengers. So 60% of women on a motorcycle that died were passengers. So the other 40% is obviously the rider themselves. But isn't that nuts? 60% of all female riders died as a passenger. This is a very bad spot. So I'm going to create a space cushion behind me. I'm going to slow down so then I have a bigger space cushion up ahead. Guys, if you're taking a woman on a ride, if you're taking your girlfriend, your wife, your sister, whoever, make sure they wear gear, okay? Make sure they are wearing gear. And make sure you actually have the training, because, man, that's insane. That's just ridiculously high. Any death is high, but, man, 91% of males, and then the females on top of that die because they're your passenger? Come on. So among the fatally injured motorcycle drivers in 2017, 28% had a blood alcohol concentration above 0.08%. Now, in Arizona, that is the legal limit, but you can still get in trouble if you have anything lower than that. And, man, there's some crazy laws here in Arizona when it comes to alcohol and riding or driving or anything like that. But, man, 28% of fatal motorcycle accident drivers, riders, whatever you want to call it, person in control of the motorcycle, had alcohol in their system at or above, not 0.04, but at 0.08 and above. Man, imagine if nobody drank and rode. Maybe 28% of those fatal accidents could be gone. So isn't that something that you could do to help minimize and reduce the risk of riding, is just don't drink and ride? Novel concept, huh? It seems like they've been talking about stuff like that forever. Of the fatal injured motorcycle drivers, 31% were not riding with a valid driver's license. Think about that. Thought experiment again. Why? Maybe you got your license revoked because you're a terrible driver. If that's the case, let's say you got a DUI, or not even that. Let's just say you got too many points on your driver's license because you're a terrible driver. You run stop signs, you speed all the time, you constantly do stupid stuff, so it's revoked. But then 31% of all fatalities in 2017 had a bad driver's license. Had no driver's license, not even a valid one. So let's think about that again. Let's kind of jump a little bit more. Let's ask another why of, well, why? Why are they speeding? Why are they doing these crazy things? Why are they getting points on their system? Well, it's because they don't have the training and they're just acting like idiots. The safety is not... I just stalled. I'm in first gear. Safety's not on their mind. If safety's not on your mind, this is what happens. You're obviously going to have a bad license. That is like the warning sign of, hey, you should probably react and drive and do all these things a lot better. So that right there is the warning sign. Huge importance, guys. Huge, huge importance. So make sure you guys are riding within your ability. And you're not going crazy and getting speeding tickets. That's a warning sign. Hey, man, you shouldn't be on the road. Get training. That's another thing that you can mitigate. Alcohol and getting training will reduce these a lot. All right, let's try this again now that I got my wallet. Pay attention. Caught you, buddy. Caught you. It's okay. Number 8. According to the U.S. Library of a bunch of medicine stuff, I'll have it annotated. I can't be reading that stuff right now. Head injury is the leading cause of death in motorcycle crashes. Wow, isn't this another thing that we can mitigate, guys? The leading cause of death in motorcycle crashes. Right here. What are we doing to mitigate this? Answer in the comments. I'm just kidding. It's a helmet, guys. Wear a helmet. Please wear a helmet. Get a full face helmet. We'll talk about why pretty soon, but get a helmet. Get something that is at minimum. I'm not even going to say DOT anymore. DOT? No. At minimum, get ECE rated helmets. ECE. Get a Snell rated helmet if you can. Get a Sharp rated helmet. Whatever all these different types are, but at minimum, get an ECE. Don't worry about DOT too much. That is like an honor system thing. I go in depth and talk about that all the time in the different videos and stuff. So just get that. Wear a helmet, guys. Mitigate that. So don't drink and ride. Have a proper driver's license, and the way to keep a proper driver's license is good motorcycle training, and then wear a helmet, mitigate some of the fatality stuff. Jeez, that's insane how everything could be mitigated. Statistics show that helmets are effective at preventing death by nearly 37% and reduce the risk of head injury by 69%. Just a helmet. Now, once again, motorcyclists, 28 times more than other vehicles on the road. So that's a huge number right there, but we can also mitigate a lot of the injuries, a lot of the problems, a lot of the bad things by having what? Gear, appropriate training, and don't drink and ride. It's crazy. I keep saying that over and over again. I want that to go inside your noggin. Oh my gosh, another study, guys. Another study, number 10. Study on helmet impacts by Dietmar. Let's get out of the way over here. Dietmar Otte, I believe that's how you say it. Shows that 66% of helmet impacts occur around the chin bar, and forehead areas. Chin bar and forehead. Chin bar, forehead. So if it happens here, what do you think happens in between? Probably gets impacted also. So that's why a full face helmet is extremely, extremely, extremely important. I hate seeing those helmets that are just like, guy, you wearing a helmet? Nope, I'm wearing a baseball cap. He should watch my video. Anyways, I hate seeing those half helmets, those brain buckets, those skull caps. 66% of the helmet impacts occur right here in the face. And I actually had to look him up. Dietmar Otte, I looked him up. He's a Hanover Medical School professor, and he works in the trauma department, I believe. So I actually looked him up. He's got a lot of citations, a lot of work. So he's actually legit, guys. I'm not making that name up. According to the Georgia Institute of Global Health, number 11, motorcycle protective clothing specifically reduced the risk of open wound injuries. There's more to this though. Motorcyclists who wear motorcycle clothing are less likely to require admission to a hospital. So think about that. Think about that. This is a two-parter actually. Open wound injuries. That could be anything. That could be anything that breaks the skin is an open wound injury. So they could probably pad their numbers a little bit. But here's the thing is that when you wear protective gear like this, and I crash and fall, and I just talked about this in a live stream recently. Guy wasn't wearing a jacket and he had open road rash on his arm. It's disgusting. And that right there is probably gonna warrant him going to the hospital. So if he was wearing protective gear and he skid, it's not gonna be there. It's gonna reduce the risk of that. If anything, it's gonna be so minor, the heat transfer from the ground to the skin because of the gear, it's gonna be so minor that it's not gonna warrant a hospital visit. Now, hospital visits are no joke here in the United States. And I understand, you know, you get the national healthcare system in other countries, but man, a hospital visit, that's a lot of money, especially for an injury from a motorcycle crash. So if you could reduce that risk by just wearing gear, a $200 jacket right here, $200, very good quality gear, quality jacket. If you can get a jacket for $200 and prevent yourself from going to the hospital just one time, pay for itself multiple times over. So wear your gear, reduce the risk of going to the hospital, and on top of that, let's say you're fine with paying the money for the hospital. What you might not be fine is having open sores, open wounds all over your body. Imagine trying to take a shower, imagine trying to work, trying to do stuff normally with like your hands ripped open, your knee ripped open, your back ripped open, all these different things because you didn't wear gear. If I had my hand ripped open, I'm sorry, but I'd rather replace my gloves than have my hand ripped open. I'm not that much of a cheapskate. Checking my rear view, getting myself in position. Got a white car coming my way. He's in the other lane. Perfect. Number 12. Now that we're at the stoplight, this is great. A study performed by Marine Corps Safety and Forest Prevention shows that wearing proper armored motorcycle boots reduced the risk of open wound injuries by 90% and the risk of any other foot injury by 45%. There's a running joke on the live streams about Nikes. I see everybody that gets in these massive crashes wearing Nikes. Or any type of sneakers. Guys, sneakers are not gear for motorcycling. I am so sorry, they're not gear for motorcycling. They are not. Do not wear that. Wear proper boots. I'm wearing proper boots. Proper boots. Wearing proper boots. It's very important that you wear proper boots because, once again, there's a study. Open wound injuries. Once again, that could be any type of road rash or impaling trauma, anything like that. Or any other foot injury by 45%. Let's just say you sprained your ankle. You set your foot down at a stoplight and it slips and you sprain your ankle, you just kind of tip over and there's no injury to you, no injury to the bike other than you have a sprained ankle. That's the other type of foot injuries. There's ankle support in these things, guys. Ankle support, very important. Now we learn all these things on the live streams, guys. On the live streams, they're very important, very informational. I go over a bunch of motorcycle accidents and crashes, I discuss them. Hour-long live streams every Tuesday and Thursday at 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, or at least Arizona time because we don't do daylight. Yeah. We just hit 400 patrons this last week. I'm super excited. Check out dfmcrew.com or beginnermotorcycletips.com for more information. But, make sure you guys swing by one of the live streams and learn a little bit extra, all right? With that said, I hope you guys ride safe, be safe, and I'll see you guys later.